Welcome to the Robin and Carol Show.
I know. Wow.
Here we go.
Should there be
Hi, Robin.
There should be a soundtrack. Hi, Carol.
How are you?
Good.
I'm so happy you're here.
Thank you. I'm happy to be here. I love being here.
Your work has those beautiful colors that make me want a raspberry sorbet.
Everybody says that to me.
Do they? Do you eat a lot of raspberry sorbet?
I do.
Do you?
No.
You don't look like it.
Sometimes I eat peach and sometimes I eat lemon too.
Do you? Is that where you get your inspiration for your color palette?
In the freezer, yeah.
In the freezer section, folks. You heard it here.
Anybody could do this. I had this huge transition about 3 years ago. I was out in California actually teaching someone asked me to go to California to teach some private lessons. I was in her magnificent home in Mill Valley. It was all glass and looking out on Mount Tamalpais. And I don't know why, I just picked up a paddle knife. I just never went back.
Nice.
Yeah.
Well, they're beautiful.
Thank you.
People love the texture, the colors just are even that much juicier, I'd say.
Yeah, it really allows me to get a lot of paint on the canvas. And I think when I set the still lifes up, I know like when I teach workshops, people are quite surprised how much time it takes me. I mean, it looks so simple what I'm painting, but how long it takes me to set it up, because I need the light to be exactly the right way, and I can't explain it, but all of a sudden, when I see it, I just stop, you know, and I just got the shivers. And then I kind of, I almost go into remote control when I'm painting, you know? You know, because I was doing underpainting, and then I start with the colors and things, and then I'm just like, ooh, you know, I love it. You know, it makes me happy. Makes me happy. Yeah.
Well, I think you are feeling that.
You do.
Absolutely. So with your still life, do you just set them up in your home, or some of them plain air?
I do both, but mostly they're set up in my studio, in my house.
Yep.
Always. I only paint from light, you know, so I have to go and buy flowers. Well, I have big gardens at my house too.
Oh, nice.
But I also, you know, buy a lot of flowers and set them up in the studio, and then I have north light all across the front, and so it's just, I work with natural light. And it's the only way I can do it.
You know, we always say that this is that bouquet of flowers that will never wilt. You know?
That is a good way of looking at it.
Absolutely.
Like, I can't even tell you how good that makes me feel. Like, that's really, when I hear that it makes people happy, someone has a painting that they look at every morning when they wake up, I do get emails and letters from people, you know, quite often telling me this, and that's...
Isn't that
it's real inspiration, to
keep going.
To keep going, yeah.
So, while you're on Martha's Vineyard, what are you going to be doing?
I'm just here for 3 days, so...
That's too short.
I know. I'm traveling with a dear friend who has to get back to his vineyard.
Oh.
So, he really can't take the time away. So.
No, that's nice. It's kind of fun to show somebody the vineyard when they haven't been here before.
Sure. He actually did. He spent a month there when he was 21.
Oh, well.
That was a long time ago.
I was not gonna go there, but
yeah.
It's fun to explore it together.
I know. Well, that's what I just want to go out and start driving around and looking at things. And
okay. Play. So you want to go out now and start driving around?
No, I mean after we finish.
Well, we can finish right now.
We can.
We can. We can just get up and go. We can do show.
No, are you gonna? Shall we do that?
Okay. We should.
Thank you, North Florida Gallery.
Thank you, Carol Maguire. Namaste.
Namaste.
Oh, goodness.
Is it time for an ice cream cone?
Might be.